Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you some of my syngoniums, the syngoniums that I'm really loving at the moment. And at the end, I'm going to give you a sneaky update on my syngonium Mojito. Let's get started. First up is this little baby. This is my syngonium Red Spot Tricolor. I love this gorgeous baby because of those colors. You've got the reds there, you've got the creams, and you've got the green. It looks absolutely stunning. Look at this new leaf that's just coming through with a lot of pink or red, whatever you want to call it in there. It looks really good. When I got this plant, it was really small. It's still quite small at the moment, but you know, I think it's going really, really well. It's living in my Italian Lecca, but look at that. This is one of the few plants that I've got living in a wick setup. So this pot is actually not sitting at the base of the cash pot and is not in actual direct contact with the nutrient solution. I've got the wicks to do that job. But look at that. How fantastic are those roots? Look at they're really long. Look! How awesome is that? You've got the secondary roots there as well. You can see those fine little roots coming out from the big root. It is just amazing. Isn't nature fantastic? That is my syngonium tricolor, looking really, really nice. I actually don't know what I'm going to do with this plant, whether I'm actually going to leave it in this little pot or put it up on a moss pole. I'm not sure. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Next up is a syngonium that I have struggled with, to be honest. This is my strawberry ice. Look at it there. Look at that leaf. Isn't that magnificent? The pink that comes through those leaves is just to die for. Look at this little one here. That's also got that magnificent pink coming through. And that's what makes this plant so beautiful. When you've got a strawberry ice just looking fantastic, it is really something to see. Like I said, this is a plant that I've struggled with in the past. I don't know why the strawberry ice doesn't like me. This is actually the second plant that I bought. My first plant just tanked. It did not do well. This one, it's also a bit iffy. I had it living in my Lecca clay balls, and then that, it was just, it wasn't really working. So I moved it to this mineral-based substrate that is sold by Tinker Garden. It is looking a bit better, I have to say. It's looking a bit more revived. So I'm not sure whether this particular plant actually prefers more moisture in the roots compared to other syngoniums that have done really well in Lecca. I don't know. But, you know, I mean, all a girl can do is try. I'm really loving how it's looking at the moment. I hope I've turned a corner with this plant. I just hope it just grows for me, because this is one plant I really, really want in my collection. But, oh, I'll show you something else that I almost forgot. Look at how it's actually starting to stalk. It's really getting long there. And I don't know whether that's telling me that I need to put it up on a moss pole. But I'm not going to waste my time putting this plant up on a moss pole until it actually shows me that it means business. So when it does, I might think about it. Next up is a really, really big plant. This is my Syngonium Confetti Elite. I don't know what the difference is between a normal Syngonium Confetti and a Syngonium Confetti Elite, but that's what the seller called it, Confetti Elite. The thing I love about the confetti is if you look at this leaf, you can see those little speckles of pink that are there. It looks absolutely brilliant. This plant I've actually kept in a, I don't know whether that's like an 18 centimeter pot. There it is. You can see those roots going through there. There's quite a number of plants in there. I think there are about five. I've been propagating since I got it because I'm really wanting to get a very, very bushy plant. And as you can see, I think I'm just about there. It's looking absolutely amazing. This plant is not giving me any trouble at all. As long as I remember to water it, it's remembering to grow. This is my Syngonium Confetti Elite. This is a small Syngonium Confetti Tricolor. So it's also a confetti, and this one is a tricolor. This leaf here is a great example. On one side of this leaf is sort of the confetti side of things, and on the other side of the leaf is the tricolor side of things. It looks absolutely brilliant. Look at that one. That looks amazing. This one is more mixed It's just a really, really interesting plant with all sorts of varied leaves. And then if you look at this leaf, that's just pink. It's really, really fun. I love it. And this is a plant that's living in my lecker clay balls, but in the submerged setup. So there's no wick. This pot actually sits directly inside that reservoir and is in direct contact with that nutrient solution, as you can see. Those are the roots of my Syngonium. Again, I will say it that, you know, once the roots of your plant start growing in the reservoir, it is actually okay. You can see what my roots are doing. That plant is absolutely fine and has been living in that reservoir for a while. So yeah, I am absolutely loving this tricolor, confetti tricolor, looking absolutely amazing. Now, if you can see over here, you can see the area roots starting to come through there. It is starting to stalk, what I like to call stalking. And at this point is where you'd seriously start thinking about putting your Syngonium on a moss pole or giving it some support, just giving it something to climb. It doesn't necessarily have to be a moss pole. And that's where things start to become tricky, because then that's when you need more space. So I don't know what I'm going to do about this particular situation, but this Syngonium is too pretty to neglect. I need to do something about that. Next up is another small Syngonium, and this one is called a Syngonium Matcha Sprinkles. The first thing I notice about this particular Syngonium is, look, you can see that is really, it's stalking. This is actually, hang on, let me position that properly. You can see that area root that's come through there, and it's actually going into the back of that leaf. This plant needs some support. It needs a moss pole, something, anything. But anyway, let me show you this Matcha Sprinkles. This was also a really small plant when I got it. But look at that. How gorgeous is that? Absolutely fantastic. This is the thing that's absolutely brilliant about Syngoniums. The variety in the patterns of the leaves is just brilliant. Even just on the same plant, no two leaves are the same. It looks beautiful. I am absolutely in love with this one. It is just absolutely doing it for me. This is my Syngonium Matcha Sprinkles. Another small one. This is a Syngonium T24. And most of these are actually quite small because I acquired them around about the same time. So this is kind of like working to be a Syngonium update video in a way. Although I'm not showing you all my Syngoniums, but yeah, here we are. So this is a T24 non-tissue culture, if anybody actually cares. Look at that. Look at that leaf. You've got that pale green there and you've got that darker green. It looks brilliant. It doesn't look as speckly or as nice as the scrambled egg Syngonium, but I am absolutely loving this T24. Look at that. It is also doing the thing, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that. Look, I love Syngoniums. I really, really do. But I'm really starting to hate this about them. And I think pretty soon I'm actually going to stop collecting them because I can't be dealing. It's just driving me insane dealing with the fact that they grow tall and you have to do something about that. So maybe this isn't the plant I'm going to actually keep collecting because it's absurd, but I love them. I absolutely love them. And this is my Syngonium T24. This is a Syngonium Pink Spot Marble. Pink Spot Marble. Look at that leaf over there. Look at this one. How gorgeous does that plant look? I mean, look at that leaf. It is absolutely beautiful. I've got a little one that's just coming through over there. Over there, that's a little pink leaf. That's going to look brilliant when that's done. This plant is also doing the stalking thing. It's getting really, really long. Going to need some support very soon. And I'll show you what those roots are doing. Look at that. That's how long this plant has been in this pot, because those roots have actually taken the shape of that cash ball. They're going around and around. I'm going to pull them out and see what they... Woo-hoo! Look at that. Look, look. Just look at that. Wow. 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 Hang on. Now, how much more evidence would someone need to prove to them that roots in the reservoir can be okay? This is it, ladies and gentlemen. This is my Syngonium pink spot marble, absolutely loving life in lecker clay balls and in that reservoir. Let's look at a Syngonium that I've actually got living on a moss pole. This is my Syngonium red spot. Oh, look at this one. This leaf is actually maturing and has taken on the shape of a mature Syngonium, which has got the three lobes there. It's trilobed, which is beautiful. Look at the reds on that leaf. This plant tells a story when I look at it. It tells me a few things about how I've managed this moss pole. It also tells me about how much light this plant has received. So, first of all, this plant started off here, these little leaves there, and that one, that was happy. This one started climbing. But you can see how the internodal spaces here, this space over here, it starts off short and it just gets longer and longer and longer. That is telling me that at a certain point over the lifespan of this plant, the amount of light that it's been receiving has been reducing. And I know that this is true. The amount of light has been reducing, and I obviously haven't been keeping the moss pole very moist. When I touch it, you can actually hear that crunch. And because I haven't been doing that and actually putting the plant really close to the pole, those aerial roots that would be formed here actually haven't formed and haven't attached to the moss pole. So this moss pole is really doing nothing for this plant, which is such a shame. And that's why haven't I done this? Because life. Because I have many plants. I need to make YouTube videos. I need to do all sorts of other things. So this is what can happen if you don't take care of your moss pole properly. But never mind that. We're here to admire this Syngonium. Look at this one. It is so cute. Look, you've got one, two, and three. It's literally three separate sections, right? You can see that there. And that's what a mature Syngonium leaf will do. But you can see how when it started, they were all joined together. So yeah, this is really fantastic. What I need to do for this plant is actually give it some rehab. I probably want to chop off this long stem bit over here. I'm going to propagate that and then eventually put it back in the pot when it's got roots. And hopefully I'm going to manage this moss pole a lot better than I have at the moment. You can actually see as well that the plant is dry. The reservoir is dry. So I don't do such a good job all the time. But also it's been very hot in Melbourne. It still is. I've literally been watering plants almost every day. It's insane. And Syngoniums actually are quite thirsty. So yeah, I'm a bit exhausted. But that is my Syngonium red spot. I love it. Here is another one of my absolute favorite Syngoniums. This is a Syngonium Grey Ghost. Oh, I love this plant. Look at that leaf. Look at how beautiful those colors are. Look at that other tiny one. Beautiful, beautiful colors. It's so gorgeous. This is another plant that I have struggled with, to be honest. My first Grey Ghost just tanked. It died. It doesn't help that with Syngoniums that are a bit rarer like these ones, you're getting a very, very small plant or just a cutting with just like one root. Things do go wrong with plants like those. So I've struggled with this. I got this new one. This one is doing really, really well. I decided I was going to put this one in a pond mixed with perlite substrate, and I think that is working really well. That's the root system of that plant over there. It's going good. And as you can see, I probably need to give it some support. But like I said, people, I don't want any more moss poles. I am really over the whole moss pole thing. I don't know what to tell you. I'm over it, but how gorgeous is that? It just needs to have a moss pole, doesn't it? Oh. If you're finding value from this video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. another Syngonium that's on a moss pole, one that is doing good this time. This is my Syngonium Frosted Heart. Look at that leaf. I love this Syngonium. I love the colors on it. I love that gray. You know, I love that almost washed out green that those leaves tend to have. And shape, the shape of the leaves of this Syngonium is fabulous. It's very different. It doesn't look like the other Syngoniums with the arrowhead type, you know, leaf. This one is different and I love it. Look at it. It's living on one of my moss poles with a plastic sheet back. It's doing okay. It's doing well. I have been struggling to keep this one with nutrient solution in the reservoir as well. It's dry. I literally watered it like 2 days ago. I'm telling you guys, it's so hot. So the minute I'm done with this video, I do need to water these plants again. But that is my Frosted Heart. I've got two plants actually on this moss pole climbing up. But how gorgeous does that look? It looks fantastic. And of course, this is what a moss pole can do for your Syngonium. Do I want a moss pole for my other Syngoniums? No, thank you. You guys know this one. This is one of my absolute faves. This is my Syngonium Mojito. Oh my, look at that. Look at these pieces of art. Oh goodness me. I cannot even. I am absolutely in awe of this plant. This plant and I have been through a lot. I've had it for a while. At least I've had various versions of this plant for a while. I've had to restart it on the moss pole a few times. I've replanted it. I've done all sorts of things. But this is where we are today. And it's looking absolutely brilliant. This is another one that's living on one of my plastic sheet back moss pole. But look at that. I mean, I'll show you the Gregor. Look, what would you rather have? That, right? It really looks amazing. Even with all my whinging about moss poles, they just do something for Syngonium. So I really probably should put my other Syngoniums on a moss pole. I've talked a lot about moss poles in this video and how difficult they can be to manage. Watch this next video where I show you a number of plants that you can have in your home that don't need a moss pole. I'll see you there.